In video 16 of the engine overhaul series, we disassembled the valves and valve springs. Not all of the cylinder heads we showed were in good condition. This does not mean that all parts need to be replaced. After a thorough diagnosis, it will show if the valves and valve springs are still reusable. This video discusses valve and valve spring diagnosis. It consists of four parts. In part 1, we will analyze the operation of valves and valve springs and explain why valves can float. In part 2, we will measure valve spring pressure at maximum valve lift. In part 3, we will show how to measure the installed length of the valve spring and measure with how much force the valve is pressed onto the valve seat. In part 4, we will perform a visual inspection of the valves, valve springs, valve spring retainers and valve keepers, and discuss specifications. Over the years of production, different types of valve springs have been used by the VW factory. Not only the dimensions have changed, but also the shape, strength and characteristics. You'll also find non-standard valve springs in old cylinder heads, such as this reinforced valve spring, pictured at right. This is a table of all valve spring specifications, summarized for all standard VW Type 1 factory engines. We will discuss in this first section, this table column by column. In the first Type 1 engines, linear valve springs were used. Later, these were replaced by progressive valve springs. This drawing from the workshop manual from 1961 through 1965 shows the old, linear valve spring on the left and the new, progressive valve spring on the right. With the linear valve spring, the distance between the windings is evenly spaced along its entire length. With the progressive valve spring, the distance between the windings changes progressively, as we show here. The VW workshop manual mentions that in early 1962, the linear valve spring was replaced by the new progressive valve spring. You will encounter both types on old cylinder heads, as VW garages could only order the new valve springs from the beginning of 1962. These are the four valve springs, which we disassembled from a 1600 cylinder head in part 2 of video 16 of our engine overhaul series. The three valve springs on the left are of the progressive type, as they should be in a younger 1600 cylinder head. One valve spring is of the linear type, it doesn't really belong here. The middle valve springs are of the same type. The left spring has thicker windings, and so will be stronger. Note that this valve spring, the dense windings are shown at the top, while on the other two progressive valve springs, the dense windings are at the bottom. Flipping the progressive valve springs is a common mistake made when installing them in cylinder heads. A progressive valve spring must be mounted with the dense windings against the cylinder head. On the right is the progressive valve spring, as it should be in a Type 1 1600 engine. On the left is the linear valve spring, which ended up in that cylinder head during a careless repair. Progressive valve springs were introduced when VW engines gained more power. This was accompanied by higher RPM. Because of the higher RPM, the old linear valve springs tended to float. To explain valve floating, we must first explain the operation of valves and valve springs in more detail. To do this, we will use the drawing we discussed in detail in video 16. This is a cross-section of a cylinder head, showing valve, valve guide, valve spring retainer, valve keepers and valve seat. To simplify the drawing, on the right, we only show the valve with its valve seat, and on the left, the valve spring with its valve spring retainer and valve keepers. The valve is pushed open by the movement of the camshaft located in the crankcase. The movement of the camshaft determines the movement of the cam followers, the pushrods, and ultimately the rocker arms. On the left, we have added the rocker arm to the drawing to better explain the operation of the valves. Here we show several revolutions of the camshaft, causing the valve to open and close. We start with a closed valve. The adjusting screw of the rocker arm does not touch the valve stem, the adjustment of the valve clearance takes care of that. The valve is pulled against the valve seat by the force of the valve spring. The length of the valve spring at rest is called the installed length. The valve spring must exert enough force in this position to pull the valve leak free against the valve seat. How much force is not mentioned in the VW manuals. But some research work for our AB1300 engine and measurement of new standard valve springs, we were able to compile this table. The installed length of the valve springs is 3.96 centimeters. The approximate pressure exerted by the valve spring to pull the valve onto its valve seat is 4.64 kilograms per square centimeter, or 35 kilograms of counterweight. So there is, as it were, a weight of 35 kilograms hanging from the valve stem, pushing the valve leak free onto the valve seat. Now imagine that the valve spring is too short, or too weak, such that it cannot exert 35 kilograms of pulling force on the valve. The valve spring will begin to rotate during valve opening and closing. This is not desirable, where will accelerate. Another problem is that the valve will be pressed against its valve seat with insufficient force, resulting in leaks. The installed length of the valve springs, and the force they exert in this position, determine the pressure with which the valves are pressed onto the valve seats. Another job of the valve spring is to close the valve when the rocker arm retracts. The more RPM the engine runs, the faster the rocker arm moves, and the more critical the valve spring becomes. If the valve spring is not powerful enough when the valve is open, then the valve may float. Valve floating happens when the valve springs can no longer follow the sudden change of direction of the rocker arms. This will happen in a standard VW engine when the valve springs are fatigued. It will also happen when the valve spring is incorrectly mounted, or when the wrong valve spring was chosen for the camshaft and valves used. The animation shows what happens when the valves start to float. The valve spring can no longer follow the rhythm of the rocker arm, the valve spring does not have enough force, or is not fast enough, to follow the sudden change of direction of the valve. The rocker arm adjustment screw loses contact with the valve stem, the valve stays open, and does not close again, before the rocker arm pushes the valve open again. This will cause a loss of compression, and thus engine efficiency. Also, what is known as backfire, which are explosions in the carburetor or in the exhaust, can occur when the valves start to float. Another possible consequence of valve springs that are too weak is that the valves start to bounce on the valve seat instead of closing tightly. We show such a scenario here. The valve spring does not have enough strength or is not suited to the engine and struggles to keep the valve closed. The valve spring should have a well-defined force when the valve is fully open. The valve spring is then compressed to its open valve length. This length is listed in VW workshop manuals as open valve length, maximum lift, or loaded spring length. Taking a 1970 AB1300 engine as an example, we see that the valve spring should be able to give a minimum of 53 kilograms of counterweight, a maximum of 61 kilograms when the valve is open. This value is measured when the valve spring is depressed to a length of 3.10 centimeters, which is the specified open valve length of our AB1300 engine. At that point, it is the strength of the valve spring that causes the valve to close. If the valve spring is not powerful enough, the valves may float or bounce. So, consulting this table is very important when measuring the valve springs. In part 2 and part 3 of this video, we will measure the valve spring pressure. From these measurements, we will be able to determine if the valve springs are reusable. You can see that VW adapted the valve springs to the evolution of the Type 1 engine. The introduction of stronger, progressive valve springs allowed the engine to handle more power and higher RPM. More information about all the parts and tools used in this video series can be found as comments under each video on our YouTube channel. See you soon.